morning, guys. Here I am at Big Pine Creek again. I'm pretty much figured this is going to probably be one of my last trips up here before the thermal water starts. And that usually happens in mid-June. July, I mean. We've been very fortunate this year so far that the water temperatures have been kept down pretty much. But Big Pine, again, is one of those creeks. It's big, it's got a lot of water, but it really, really warms up fast. So I'm back here at my honey hole. I know at the beginning of the season, all I kept on saying is I had a fish here, I had a fish there, because of all the low water, I mean all the high water. Now it seems Pine Creek is pretty much it, because all my other creeks, the water is so low. I know this area down here has an abundance of trout still in it. Whether I'm going to be fortunate enough to get back into them like I had in the past. It's been about a week and a half since I've been up here. And the water has just steadily gone down, so it's really going to be some light tippets. I'll probably be using my 2-weight Orvis power matrix rod. I won't go much lower than a 6X tippet. I'm just not going to wrestle with a 7X. Just not going to do it. And I do believe the right presentation will produce more fish than real light tippets. Fly line doesn't scare the fish. Or the tippet doesn't scare the fish. It's the wrong presentation that scares the fish. So I'm just trying to be careful. It'll probably be some long cast, but we'll see. So with that, wish me luck. I'm going down the path now to the honey hole. See you on the creek. Welcome to the honey hole. Here we go. Walked down this morning. Seen a rise right there in the shoreline. I'm thinking it's a cruiser. One of these trout or smallmouth are just cruising around the shoreline. But I'm not seeing any rises yet. Hopefully, fingers crossed, get some rises. I want to walk up towards the fast water, or may I say the faster water, because none of this water is running really fast. Oh, there, yep, they're raising. There was a raise right down there directly. So yeah, they're doing their thing. Gonna go out to my usual spot, I hope. Just walk straight out. I put a light Cahill on again. Seems to be my producing fly in this area. Of course, if they don't take that, then we start going through the box. I tied some new Clinkhammers, and I tied a version of mine of what I'm calling a Clinkhammer Cahill. I also tied some high vis Griffith gnats. I used one of them, which was a size 18 last time out, but I had no luck on it. Well, there's not a lot of fish raising, so there's not a lot floating on the water, which might be good for me. Because they might readily take my selection. Instead of having an ample amount of food to feed on. So we'll see. Okay. Wish me luck again. Well, there are a few fish that I have found that are raising. So we hope for the best. And when I started up here this morning, I mean it poured down rain. Coming up that road, I thought, oh, but it was supposed to rain like at 7 o'clock, and I do believe it did right on cue, which is okay with me because it stopped now. But wasn't dumb this time. I put my raincoat in my back, my backpack, and think that these fish here are going to be very easy to pull. Believe me, I do not. I want to feel fortunate, that's all I can say. Here we go with our first one. I took that like Cahill. Well, at least we got one. We got one of something. Get him to the net. We got a rainbow here. Not a bad looking one either. He's tired. Get his head up. He's got that fly right in the top of his mouth. Get him back in the water just as soon as possible. Well, he did have that fly in the top of his mouth. And I can see it in my net now, so. Good barbless hooks. It should come out okay. But he's still tangled up. There you go. Yeah. And there we go. Put your little butt back in there. You feeling okay, fella? Come on now. Oh yeah. He's swimming off slow, but he's swimming off. Whew. Like I said, using barbless hook. And there's that Cahill again. Man, you gotta tie some of those fellas. Okay, I changed flies, and I changed it to a Fontaine caddis pupa. First cast, caught a fish. They were taking my light Cahill submerged. And they were taking it on top of the water. So that's what led me to believe that I should go to my La Fontaine, which is very good in this kind of situation. And right now it seems to have worked for this fish, hopefully. I can make it work for a few more fish. But you can believe not only me, but other people have fished over these guys and pretty wary, I'll tell you. Having some trouble with my knots too, because that light Cahill that I had, I lost to a fish, and it was right at where the knot tied in, so to the hook. So I don't know. Maybe these old eyes just aren't doing it anymore. I don't. Oh well. Quick release. Maybe we could get this guy to cooperate and come up here. Ooh, right on the top. Right there on the top of the mountain, that rainbow got it. It's a hefty one too. Wow. Sorry, but I gotta use the forceps. I can't get a hold of that little. Ah, we got her out. Okay. Another nice rainbow. Get him back in the water. That guy was very much alive when I let him go. Not for the worse. So we'll just see if this caddis poop is gonna help me. She is a good fly, I'll tell you that. I've caught so many fish on this fly. Good about it is they'll even take it on a drag. caddis poopy is underneath the surface. I don't know if it's going to work like that Cahill did, but well, there you go. I guess it was worthwhile that I tied that clinkhammer. Picked him, missed one on a clinkhammer. And then I picked this one up. Finding my dang net today. I know it's on my back. Jeez. Hello. I think I got a brown trout here. Not sure. About ready to find out. Yeah, got me a brownie. Go. Yeah, not a bad little brownie. Cute little bugger. Okay, whoa, is he ready to go? I'm gonna gunk this fly up. This clinghammer. I'm just gonna leave it go down in a film. Boy, I tell you what, it seems that's what I tell you. That's my clinghammer. And it's working for two fish so far.